over here, and today I am doing a Pennsylvania haul because these are so much fun to do. So I'm going to start off with the smallest and work my way to the biggest bag. And I'm probably going to need my purse as well because it's got the receipt from Fashion Sense. And we're going to need that. So, let's do this. Okay, first, the first thing that I got, and probably the longest thing that I'm just going to show you, is 10,000 Villages. I got this set of like three masks. We have a box and an owl that kind of looks like it's got some Harry Potter glasses going on, and a cat. And it's also got some ribbon in here so you can, you know, tie it on. And it also has a little thingy so you can fit these skewer onto them. Thicker than I thought they'd be. But that's okay. We'll make it work. And in here, somewhere there. Ah, here it is. Okay, I'm probably going to pronounce this wrong, but these were made in Khurshi, Bangladesh. Meaning Khurshi, meaning nature, and Belgian is an agency that provides mandrel, I think, product design and development and marketing assistance to handicraft organizations in Bangladesh. Khurshi, I think. Manages several handicraft enterprises and helps other groups sell their products in local and foreign markets. Central offices and a local outlet stores are located in Dhaka. While the enterprises are located around the country. Khurshi, I'm going to try every way of pronouncing this because I have no idea. And its enterprise provides jobs for the poor, rural women, widows, divorces, or head of household. Primarily rural, landless, and with little to no income. By providing jobs for the women, Khurshi improves women's standard of living and helps them send their children to school. The organization provides skills development training to artisans. The design department of Khurshi is committed to developing marketable designs based on Bangladesh's cultural heritage. Khurshi creates and promotes income generated generating projects that benefit the artisans, adhere to good safety and environmental standards, and have the potential to become self-reliant. So Crete was established in 2001 as an independent organization. It grew out of the marketing operations of Mennonite Central Committee, Bangladesh's Job Corporation Program. That's a mouthful. Operating since 1975, Procrete is committed to fair trade principles. 10,000 villages purchase handmade paper items. Oh, no. Ceramics, palm leaf and paper ornaments, and jute, hemp and coconut fiber items from Procrete. 10,000 villages has purchased products from Procrete and its predecessor, MCC Bangladesh, in 1986. Procrete was established in 2001, having grown out of the MCC Bangladesh Job Creation Program. Procrete presently manages 7 handcraft enterprises representing some 90 artisans. Procrete artisans use natural and leftover raw materials in producing handcrafts. Procrete enterprises use environmentally friendly azo-free dyes that bind directly to the material and do not have colored water waste. Currently, 10,000 villages carry handmade paper products, garlands, ornaments, lampshades, terracotta planters, baskets, and table runners from Procrete. And then there's their website. So that's basically the background information that they give you whenever you would purchase this set. And I got this for $9.50. It was marked way down. So yeah, it's supporting a good cause, so that's how come it's a little more expensive than the other items that I bought. But yeah. And then next, I got from this ice creamery that we always go to, and I'm always finding unique things at. I got this. I don't know if you can see this from here. Yeah, you can. Okay, let me get in closer. It's this icy flavored spray candy. And it's got this cool packaging that just looks like a miniature icy. And this was $1.99. And I got that because I'm going to try it on what's in your treat bag. Yeah, it's fun. Oh, great. Yeah, yeah. Okay, also, I got this cool pack of gum that also looks like crayons. Ooh, and there's a sticker inside. I mostly got it just because it looks like crayons, and I got this for $1.50. And also, I'm going to try this one that I like. I mean, not done, I like.
What's in your treat bag?
Can you tell it's been a long 3 days? Okay, moving right along to the Disney Store bag. I always have fun at the Disney Store. Okay, so. The first thing that I got was a Winnie the Pooh plushie. It's background information on this and why I got a Winnie the Pooh plushie, because this kind of really, this probably seems really out of nowhere for you guys, but ever since I watched the trailer for Christopher Robin movie that's coming out, and I don't even know when, but it's coming out sometime soon. Anyway, ever since I watched the trailer for the first time, I've just been really nostalgic for Winnie the Pooh, and I just got really excited for the movie and stuff, and so I kind of wanted to have another large Winnie the Pooh plushie, because I got rid of all my childhood large Winnie the Pooh plushies, because they either glowed in the dark or talked or something. So I just wanted, like, a regular Winnie the Pooh plushie because, you know, the Christopher Robin movie is coming out, and I just got so nostalgic for Winnie the Pooh stuff lately because of the movie. So that's why I got this. And he was $12 before tax. I don't remember. Hold on, I got the receipt in here still. Oh, yes, $12. Let me get this kajinker out of your armpit. Alright. They had this, he was specially marked for $12 because, you know, there was just so much clearance going on in the Disney Store at the time. When I go to see said Christopher Robin movie, and it says easy breezy days, and it's got all the Winnie the Pooh characters except for Kanga and Roo and Owl, and okay, so it's got some of the Winnie the Pooh characters right here, like Eeyore, Tigger, Pooh, and Piglet, and a tree, and it looks cute. And this is an extra small lady, because I am an extra small lady. So, yeah. I just want to hug him forever, forever. He smells like cardboard, though. This shirt was $5.99 because no tax in Pennsylvania on clothes. And I thought there was tax on this, but apparently there was not. Or maybe I just did not see it when I looked at the receipts. Hold on. Oh, yeah, there was tax. 72 cents worth. that's what I got from the Disney store. And now it's time to get into the main attraction of this hall, the Fashion Sense Hall. Because I think I had like the best success this time around. I feel like I say this every time that I do a haul for Fashion Sense, but this time I think it really legit is my best time around. I purposely did not take the tags off of anything, and I purposely left the receipt in my purse right here so I can tell you guys every single exact price of everything. So, let's get into it. And I'm just going to go in random order. Wait. Okay, first things first, I got these super fun LuLaRoe paper airplane pants. Leggings, really. And they just were so cool and so cute, and they made me think of my dad, so I got them. And I got these for, I'm just looking at the receipt. I don't have time to look at all these things. Leggings. I got these for $6.79. And that's really, really good for name brand LuLaRoe items. I mainly got these because I had never seen this design of LuLaRoe pants before. Like, I've never seen this paper airplane fabric before, and I really liked it. It had a nice kind of nerdy vibe, in my opinion. So, I got them. So, yeah. Let's get this off of here. And that has, I don't know if the color of the tag has anything to do with how much savings is on it, but this has a green tag. It probably doesn't. Okay, so there's that. Then next I got this beautiful black dress with some white, like, cool accents on it. I'm telling you guys, if there's a dress out there with cool overlay and it's in my size, I'm gonna get it because I just have like a huge weakness for dresses with tulle overlays, or any overlay for that matter. Okay, so I got this lovely little thing wait, what's the size on this? Because not surprising, because I love Speechless's dresses, apparently. Okay, is it small? Girl small dress, probably. Hold on. Then I got this for $5.09. And it is just adorable and beautiful, and I love it. Let me give you a moment more for a long look at it. That looks cool. Fell in love with when I tried it on. This beautiful pink and white dress. It's kind of similar to another dress that I got the last time I went thrifting. I didn't do a haul for that one because I only got two things. But it's a different cut than this dress, if that makes sense. This one is more a poofy skirt, and it's really fun and lightweight, and I like it. And I got this for $3.39. Now, if you're wondering how come all this stuff was even cheaper than it usually is from Fashion Sense, that's because they were having a special deal because it was around Easter time when I went. So they had like 15% off a lot of stuff in the store. I'm not going to say everything because I'm pretty sure there were a couple of things that they had just gotten that were not a part of that. But moving on. Next we have this very nice green and black, like, cheetah print jacket. It's a really nice fit on me. It's very comfortable, very soft, and I really, really like it. And I got this for $2, I believe. No, I actually got this for $1.70. Yeah, it was $1.70. Did I take the tights off of the bag? No, I did not. Owie! But yeah, great find right here. And it made me think of like the camo jackets that Graveyard Girl, which if you don't know who that is, she makes like videos on YouTube. She's, most of them are makeup based, but she also does like does this really work where she tries out As Seen on TV stuff. And she just loves her camo, and this made me think of her. And all the camo coats that she's obtained over the years. Oh, it's Easter colors! Okay, we're down to the final two items, I believe. Yep. Okay. Okay, the last item and the most expensive item I think that I got. Probably if I had taken, wait. Yeah. Probably if I had taken like more time and thought about it, I probably would have thought this would have been a little too much for the given item, but it was a name. But again, it was a brand name, so that's probably what justified it in my head. Anyway, so I have a LuLaRoe shirt, and it's all soft, and it's got this fun print on the sleeves, and it still has the tags on it, so supposedly it's brand new. And I got this for $8.50. Like I said, the most expensive thing that I bought from Fashion Sense this time around. There we go. It's kind of weird to me that I find stuff with the tag still on it at places like Fashion Sense, because it's like, did you like get it as a gift and hate it or something? Like, what, in what case scenario would you have clothes in your possession with the tag still on them that you want to get rid of? That just boggles my mind. Finally, we have this fun little tank top. Very light, very airy. Made me think of the Lion King. And I got this for $1.70. Very nice deal. There we go. Okay. So that is all the stuff that I got in Pennsylvania the last time I went, with the exception of two items, because those two items are refrigeratable and I don't want to take them out just to show you guys. So you'll see those next time. Well, not next time, but another time, because I'm going to be doing paid guest videos with them. And I'll see you guys next time.